Dr. Pawluk, thank you for being here with us. How did it all start?
I started doing magnetic therapy because as a family doctor, I knew that I was not helping people, that I was hurting people by giving them medications that in the long run would actually hurt them more. And so I started studying other types of techniques of helping people, like acupuncture and homeopathy and natural medicine, energy medicine, and eventually began to use magnetic therapies. And the more I used them, the more amazed I became at how effective they were. And I essentially stopped using a whole lot of other therapies because these were so effective.
And what conditions do you treat with magnetic therapy?
Magnetic therapy basically works in such a fundamental way in the body, it almost doesn't matter what the condition is, because it's treating the cells, it's treating the tissues, it's treating the organs. But the conditions that we tend to use it for the most is for pain. And pain is extremely common in the United States and Canada.
Well, I know that some medical experts estimate that some 50 million people in the U.S. and Canada suffer from chronic pain. So what are the traditional ways of addressing this pain?
Most doctors would prescribe medications, would do injections, would do procedures. In other words, they cut into the body, so they do surgical procedures. There's a whole host of what we call basically invasive techniques. And the medications, unfortunately, are not what we call innocuous. They have risk. In fact, a lot of people die from medications for pain management. 16,000 people a year die from using ibuprofen-like medications. A year. 16,000 people die a year just for their pain management. So we have to find a better alternative. That's a stupid idea.
So what types of magnetic therapies are there?
There are many types. The two basic forms of magnetic therapy are what we call static and pulse magnetic therapy. So static magnetic therapies are basically like refrigerator magnets, or what you put shoe inserts in, or you wear belts or necklaces or bracelets. Those are static magnetic fields. They don't go very deep in the body, and so they don't work that effectively. They work, but not that effectively. Pulse magnetic fields, on the other hand, what we call low-frequency pulse magnetic fields, go all the way through the body. It's like the wind blowing in the trees. It goes all the way through. And as a result, they help to restore circulation, they reduce swelling in the tissues, they reduce pain in the tissues, they help the tissues regenerate themselves, and just a whole host of healing effects. And if you do the healing work in the tissues, then you stop the pain. You gradually reduce the pain. That's the better way to do it, not just to kill the pain. I call it numbing and dumbing the pain. Let's help the body to heal itself, and the pain will get better anyway.
Well, right, because pain is an indicator of something being wrong in the body. So if you just treat the pain, you basically ignore the symptoms of the real problem. So what you're saying is that you're dealing with the actual problem.
Using painkillers or the procedures is basically a Band-Aid, mm-hmm. Right? Whereas this actually helps to heal the tissues. So we have the chance over a long period of time of use, home use with magnetic therapies, you have the chance of healing the tissues. And not just the pain, because often what I find is that people will have a pain problem, but then they apply to their shoulder and something else that was wrong with their shoulder will get better. Or they put it over their abdomen and the liver got better. Or they put it over their heart or a headache, etc. So many, because it's, again, it's operating at so many different levels, it's not just what you chose it for.
Now, what types of magnetic treatments are the most sort of popular or the favorites among patients?
Which devices? You have basically two types of, there's different ways of categorizing. You have devices that cover the entire body. You have devices that are essentially local treatment devices. And then you have devices that are very powerful and devices that are very weak. So there's many categories, and people have to sort of figure out for themselves which is likely going to be the best approach. Cost is a major issue. So there are devices, for example, I use devices that are $20,000. And on the other hand, we have devices that are about $550. And between that, we have a price range of $2,000, $3,000, $5,000, $6,000. So cost is a major consideration. But ease of use, ease of applying it to the body, putting it in different places, the amount of time that you have to use to treat yourself to get the results, these are all factors in considering which device to choose.
Right. Well, but I mean, which types are the most accessible, and what has the most success among those who use them?
Well, and one of the reasons I'm here today is because one of my favorite set of devices are these two that we have on the table here. Mm-hmm. So the LMAG itself, for example, this is called the LMAG. Mm-hmm. It's four coils. It's very easy to use, and you can apply it to various parts of the body. So for myself, if I have a neck pain, I can drape it around my neck. If I have a back pain, I can basically put it on the back of the chair and it covers the entire spine. So if my hips are bothering me, I can put it in the front or put it on the chair and I take care of my hips. My knees, I can just put it over my knees. So I can locate it in different places. It's easy to use, runs, just plug it into the wall and it just runs, you know, basically for like 15 minutes and you can just keep recycling it.
And how do you know how, you know, basically without the benefit of a doctor being there with you, how do you know how to use it and not to overuse it, not to hold it too long, too short? How do you know these things?
Well, fortunately, if you're getting it through drpawluk.com, then we often advise people on how to use this. There's a really good manual that comes with this. It's written in Russian and in English. So that manual is pretty self-explanatory. It's virtually impossible to do any harm to yourself because the intensity, while it's reasonably high, you really can't hurt yourself. It's not like power line fields. It's not like Wi-Fi or cell phones. It's very, very safe technology.
Well, that was actually one of my questions because we're surrounded by magnetic fields. There is a magnetic field of the Earth. There is a magnetic field of all the devices that we use. I mean, we're really surrounded in, you know, by these multiple magnetic waves. So does this device complement them? Does it, you know, can it come in conflict with them? Is it really safe?
It's very safe. The types of fields you're talking about are generally not good for us. They're good for communication if you've got a cell phone, but it's high frequency fields, high intensity. They actually causes radiation and actually heats tissues. That's not healthy. Pulsed magnetic fields, on the other hand, are designed specifically to stimulate the tissues of the body without causing any harm. In other words, they do not heat the body or harm the cells.
So basically, there are good magnets and there are bad magnets.
There are good magnetic fields and there are bad magnetic fields, correct. And these are good magnetic fields, or I wouldn't be using them. And I've been using magnetic therapies for over 20 years.
Well, what has, have you used them on yourself?
I use it on every day. I have shoulder problems and knee problems and back problems, tendonitis problems, headaches. I mean, I use it all the time. I even use it on my dogs. The LMAG, I have a West Highland Terrier, Westie, who has Lyme disease. And the Westie competes with my wife for time on the LMAG. I mean, my wife would be sitting there using the LMAG and the Westie's looking at her, get off, I want my LMAG. Wow. She loves it.
Okay, so basically what we see is that just by buying this product, somebody can, without going to a doctor, treat their own conditions of all sorts.
Again, very safely. And the good thing about this is the key to chronic pain management is you got to do it yourself every day. Going to a doctor is, you know, giving money to the doctor, and that can sometimes be effective. And sometimes you only need to go to the doctor 3 or 4 times and you're done. But most chronic pain problems need chronic care. They need daily ongoing care for years and years often. And that's what the value of these systems is.
Well, and you were saying that there are other devices that you think are more effective, that maybe you're using the ones that are costing thousands of dollars.
Right.
So when people come to you, what's the difference between this and, say, more comprehensive, bigger machines in your office?
Well, the LMAG and the megaphone, and this is the megaphone device, and this one has sound, ultrasound, basically. It uses sound frequency, so it has the magnetic field and has sound. So when you put it, say, on a tendonitis on your shoulder, you're getting the benefit of both sound and magnetic field therapies. So that's another alternative to the LMAG. So if you need that high intensity local push, then you would use a megaphone. On the other hand, some problems need high intensity. For you to get relief more quickly, you need a higher intensity system. The LMAG and the megaphone basically have one frequency. Sometimes the body needs different frequencies. There are things we call windows in the body. And different processes, different tissues, different issues in the body will respond better with a variety of frequencies. And so we have devices that will cover, you know, all of those kinds of possibilities.
So basically, one is a magnetic device and one is magnetic and almost like an ultrasound.
Exactly.
Device.
That's the megaphone.
Uh-huh. And again, you use it just by applying it
local,
on your
just,
body.
Just the specific spots.
Interesting. And so when people get these, again, what types of, I don't know, diseases or what types of conditions have they been able to cure?
Well, I don't use the word cure, right? We can't honestly say that we're curing something. We're really helping the body to heal itself. Mm-hmm. So pain is clearly an issue. So you have arthritis. you have spinal stenosis or back pain, you have a neck pain, you have tendonitis, fractures. My wife broke a toe and her toe was bent out. I put magnets on the toe, and within 3 or 4 days she was walking in regular shoes again. Normally it would take 2 to 3 weeks at least for her to be able to do that. So Lyme disease is a good example. You got aches and pains all over the place, and what you do is you help medications and you help herbs and supplements and even nutrition work better in the tissues by exposing the tissues to the magnetic fields. I have a gentleman who uses the LMAG for his asthma. He came to me from the University of, actually from Johns Hopkins University. A professor was taking care of him, but it wasn't getting.
So it works in combination, as everything else, it works in combination with other methods to get a person better.
It can work alone, but yes, I don't normally advise you to use it just by itself.
How can we find out more information about this? Because there's a lot, it seems like there's a lot to know in a short period of time. Is there a place where we can find out more information?
Well, for these two devices specifically, the website almagia.com has information specifically for these. If you want to know more of the science on magnetic therapies, you want to know more about how they work and which devices to get, then I recommend people go to drpawluk.com. And I believe you'll have that on the banner or whatever.
And how can these be ordered?
Through either website.
And how much are these devices?
The Almagia is the LMAG is typically about $550. Mm-hmm. The Megaphone is a bit more expensive than that, but it's not much more expensive.
I see. Well, I was just it's a revelation to me that magnetic field can do that much. It's strange to think that nobody has really discovered this before.
Well, they did. Actually, I wrote a book, Magnetic Therapy in Eastern Europe. And that book reviewed the scientific literature coming out of Eastern Europe, Russia, the Ukraine, Bulgaria, the Czech Republic, you know, all these Eastern European countries. They've been using these technologies for almost half a century. And so we summarized that literature because most of it was in the Cyrillic alphabet, mm-hmm. right? So in the West, it was not available in the West. I met up with a doctor from the Czech Republic who read Russian, mm-hmm. and he translated a lot of that literature, and we put it into a book, which is really a technical book. It's not something for the public to use, but that basically told me what the history of magnetic therapy was and how much experience the Eastern Europeans have had with this. If you talk to a common person in Eastern Europe today and ask them about magnetic therapy, they will have heard about it. You talk to an average American or Canadian about magnetic therapy, they say, what are you talking about?
Why do you think in a country like the U.S. that is so obsessed with health and with healthy lifestyle, such an amazing sort of therapy and device is just not so well known?
Well, that was a question that we dealt with on Dr. Oz. I was on the Dr. Oz show talking about these kinds of things, and Dr. Oz made that point very clearly. So your doctor doesn't know about it. He actually prepared a sheet for people to give to their doctors so they could get permission from their doctors to be able to use the technologies. But the problem is the doctors just don't know about it. They don't know about it for several reasons. Number one, it's not part of established medicine. So it's considered fringe, even though there's good science. We use MRIs, we use FDA-approved devices for healing bones. There are devices that are approved by the government and doctors do use them. But when you go outside the normal sort of parameters of what's approved by insurance companies and the government, now people sort of freeze at that point, but they don't understand the reason it works. And if you don't understand the reason, then you are limited in how you would use it. So that's why the primary reason is that they just don't know. There's always also the possibility of arrogance. And for some doctors, it's a bad idea because it takes money out of their pocket.
Well, it seems like it's a good idea for people to sometimes take their own health in their own hands. So I hope that more people find out about your therapies and benefit from them.
Thank you.